I said, hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we can find ourselves a brand new recipe? Mr. Bob Gother on the Electric Telecaster. With Carmen C, I said, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Carmine Sato.
Say, you're the guest artist.
That was great.
Nothing? Great. Okay, well, then I'll start talking.
The pressure.
Too much pressure around
here.
So we're back up here at Carmine's Country Corner. You know, next month, in a few weeks, it's going to be 4 years. And we never miss a Sunday except for when I'm out of town. And then we do like a rerun. You know, we pull something out of the past with somebody good on and in fun, and we just see you guys still get to see something. I'm going to come this way a little because I'm banging into Paul over here. And Paul, you know, Paul pulled up with his white hat on, and I said, I think I'll wear my white hat because I always wear black or gray or something. So it's kind of big, I think, but I mean, it fits me good, but I think for my size, I think the brim
is
too big.
Side of the stage.
Now, you never wear a hat, Jerry. Get up here, talk to me for a minute.
If the glue melts on the hair, then I put the hat on.
Well, you know, I'm going to tell you something. If I had a head of hair like you got, I wouldn't wear a hat either. But
I think John Palmer wins the hair.
John's got the hair contest thing going. Yeah, he might win that one, I got to tell you. Me, I lost about 30 years ago, right downhill. Anyway, we're coming to you from Bob Smith Toyota. I went out. We got another computer. We set a bunch of stuff up. My daughter Kim, who works so hard on this show, you don't know what goes on behind the scenes. It's all love stuff, you know, labor of love. We all have fun. Dan Hugot probably is more concerned about what's going on here than any of us, including me.
You can see the concern on his face.
I'm telling you,
all over.
Is that what that look is?
So I get this new computer. Listen to this one, and it comes with a new keyboard, which we didn't use anyway because the other keyboards are. But it comes, and there's a little tiny piece of plastic that means nothing. It's not part of the function of what the thing does, but it's on the corner, and I guess in shipping it had chipped off. And Dan would not go any further till he crazy glued that little piece of plastic back on that keyboard, I mean, that's how much it was bugging me. I would have said, let's just go.
Dan's like,
don't worry about it.
I thought you were going to tell me he sent it back.
No. Oh, no. I'm not, I never send anything back. I'm not going
to
do that.
JPL, they keep trying to hire him, but he turns them down.
He's way too tough for those guys. So, Jerry, you've been working a lot.
Yes, I have. You know, sometimes, Carmine, people get desperate, and they call me.
Well, I got to tell you what, they're not very desperate because they're not calling me anymore. I can tell you that much. But anyway, and I want to thank you. Did all you folks out there watching the show or checking us out every once in a while, he put up a beautiful a promo thing, whatever you call it, the picture of the sign, Carmine's Corner, with a beautiful green thing on the bottom with all. You really made it look professional. Thank you. You made us look good.
Well, you know what they say. It's better to look good. Than it is to sound good.
Well, they do call it show business.
Yes.
It's not sound business or anything else. Okay, we're gonna go on with the show. Do another one, and then we'll get the guys to go around the horn here.
6 days on the road.
Let's do it.
Trucker music for my buddy Tim Armstrong is out there on the road.
There you go.
Driving the big rig.
Get home tonight. I got 10 forward gears in a Georgia overdrive. I'm taking little white pills and my eyes are open wide. Just passed to Jimmy and a white, long passing everything in sight. 6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight. Gary Swan on the piano. Well, there's a flame from a stag and the smoke is blowing black as coal. Well, nothing bothers me tonight. I see my hometown coming into sight. 6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight. That's right. 6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight.
Boy, I'll tell you, when Jerry's in the house, it rocks. You know, the whole building moves when this guy plays. Love you, man. We go way back, and I'm glad we do because you're a good guy.
Is that East Coast?
No, yeah, absolutely, man. Jeez. How many years were you a teacher?
About 140 years.
No, come on, really. How many years?
That's how much it ages you.
Yeah.
Well, 34 years.
Was it 34? Now, did I know you, I think, before you were a teacher?
You might have.
I think I did.
Yeah.
So you got smart and I didn't. I kept, you know, I don't know how that happened.
I didn't get smart. I got a phone call.
I didn't.
It's like, hi, sweetheart, I'm pregnant.
Yeah. Gotta get a
get
job.
Get a job.
By the way, Jerry's working at the comedy club down the street this Saturday.
Yeah, right. Anyway, so God bless you, man.
Thank you.
And I'm going to come over to your house for lessons, not guitar lessons. I want you to teach me some stuff. You know, how to read.
Never
how
start
to
a
add,
sentence with and.
You know, it's that kind of stuff. Anyway, if you were as good a teacher as your guitar player, you're one hell of a teacher.
I don't know. Every once in a while, a student shows up at a gig and they're just pointing and laughing.
Yeah. Well,
which is what, you know.
I'm sorry, but I got to do this.
Carmine.
I didn't ask about the family. I completely forgot.
Oh, man.
So forgive me. How are you doing?
Families. Everybody's better.
Colleen's not coming today? Is she here?
No, she's holding a kid party at home.
Oh, man, well, those are always fun.
But I got a bunch of our kids and neighbors' kids.
Oh, that's you know,
good.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
And Bobby, thanks for coming up. I haven't seen you in a few weeks.
I've been working.
Well, good.
I've been working on
making
the,
money.
In the coal mine, you know.
You know, I was talking to my buddy Tom down at Knoxbury Farm. I play down there quite a bit. And with this guy, Tom Corbin, I think his name is. Nice. Yeah, I think you know
Bert,
Tom. Yeah, Corbin.
Tom. Yeah.
Great guy, good singer, good player. And we were thinking, gee, maybe we're getting too old to do this, he was saying, because Knott's been kind of cutting back in the music. So he was kind of thinking maybe they want to get like some younger guys in there. And I can dig it, you know. So I told him, I said, listen, we always got Carmine's Country Corner. Don't worry about it. He said, hey, you don't know how much better I feel. I said, that doesn't pay anything, but we'll get to play. So,
they said we wanted. They said to you, we wanted younger guys. And you said, I know a couple guys, 74, 75.
Yeah, shoot, yeah. I'm going to be 80 in about 8 weeks, in June 29th. What, Susie?
Speaking of that, Sunny Weiss is here.
Oh, Sunny. That's who that beautiful woman was. I can't say the word woman for some reason today. Well, Sonny, I love you. How's Marie doing? And the other, your other daughter and all the grandkids? I always see you on Facebook. You got a great family. Wonderful. Well, good to see you. I want to thank you for coming up. And have some cookies and cake and something, you know. Okay, Paul.
Okay.
It's your turn.
Key of D.
Key of dog, okay.
Please help me, I'm falling in love with you. Close the door to temptation. Don't let me walk through. Turn away from me, darling. I'm begging you to. Please help me, I'm falling in love with you. I belong to another whose heart has grown cold. Though she promised forever,
love and to hold. I can never be free, dear, but when I'm with you, I know that I'm losing the will to be true.
Country Corner, coming to you from Bob Smith Toyota. I think we still got the sign on the drum. And we've been up here a long time in this place. We haven't gotten thrown out yet, Paul.
4 years. No.
It's been a while.
No, they're very tolerant.
Boy, I'll tell you.
No,
but we're having a good time.
I don't think they know we're here.
Yeah.
No, the bees almost threw us out one time.
Boy, remember when the bees were here? All the fun we had? Unbelievable. Bob Gotha, you want to do something?
Yeah, let's do that Cretan song that I was going to do last time.
The creepy song that
it's called Lodi.
And let's do it.
It goes from G to A. Then when, on the modulation, we're all going to play.
Yeah.
All right? Not together, but you know, we're going to take turns. Well, here we go.
Oh, now we're turning again. One, G. Yep. One, two, three, four.
Looking for a pot of gold. was on my way. Somewhere I lost connection. I ran out of songs to play. I came into town, a one-night stand. Looks like my plans fell through.
Bob did that song in this show about a year or so ago. He went through the whole song without doing a solo, and I said, Bob, I said, let's play a solo in that song. And there really is not a solo in that song. They have a turnaround, but the guitars don't actually play. They just do like a signature kind of a turnaround thing. I said, yeah, but we want to play solos. So he comes in and says, I found the perfect spot. And you did. And right after the modulation. Right. And you know what? It sounded great. And thank you for that.
And you guys said it all. I didn't need to play one. You guys said it all.
Oh, we had fun.
Carmen
had
said fun. To him, said to Bob, Bob, look at the sign.
Yeah. Carmine's Country Corner. I want to play the guitar. I always tell the guys, do me a favor. I mean, there's a lot of songs don't have solos, but I don't sing very much. All I do is play guitar. So when you hear you doing a song, I want to play a solo. I don't care what it is. I just want to play. And they're kind enough to do that. And so thank you all.
You bet.
So, Swan, you've been ducking all night. Come on. But right after you, we've got to get Jerry back up, our guest artist. Hey, we might go a little over tonight. If this time flies by, I'm gonna go a little over. Yeah, I think we're okay. Go ahead, Gary.
Yeah, I started loving you. I'm right back where I've really always been. I got over you just long enough. You let my heart ache, man. But today I started loving you again. What a fool I
I love the way, if I could sing, that's one of the guys I would want to sing like, right there, Gary Swan. Wait, okay. Susie jumped up and pointed at me, and I'll tell you what, we don't let that go by. What do you got, babe? John Beelen? Well, tell him to come down and do the show and quit fooling around. John Beelen, I met him in 1968, and I've known him ever since.
I know John Beelen.
John Beelen's a good cat. He's been everywhere twice, and he knows what he's doing. What's all this back?
I love you, John Beelen. You know that.
Shout out. Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, John Beelen, everybody up here seems to know you, and we all seem to like you. So good. So come down and do this show. And tell Clara we said hi. She's got this beautiful lady. She's just lovely. And I'd like to meet her one day.
Every time I see a Facebook post from John, he's like in a different part of the country.
Yeah. Well,
so why can't
everywhere.
He come here?
Well, I don't know.
Come on, John.
There might be some legal trouble there.
It couldn't be the pay. The pay around here is pretty good.
I don't know the man, but I'm just saying.
Yeah, it could be. It could be.
I won't stop you from speculating.
G, kind of up. Blue and broken hearted me. Holding to a memory. If I had you, I would not be blue and broken hearted me. That's the whole song. I never felt so down and out. Never felt so all without. Since you've been gone, no matter what I try to be, blue and broken hearted. Bob Gothard. Thank you. wheel. Since you've been gone, no matter what I try to be, I'm broken hearted. But every tear I cry is real. Since you've been gone, no matter what I try to be, Bobby, you're next. Blue and broken heart. Yeah. But I just wanted to kind of play with Jerry at the same time and step all over him, and same thing with Bob. Because Bobby and I have done that many times. He's been up here a lot. So I want to thank you all for watching the show. Please push the old like button and the old share button. And if you're watching this on YouTube, it'll be up on YouTube probably by tomorrow sometime. Push the subscribe button when you're on YouTube. I want to thank all you people for coming out. Let me see. We got a little audience. One, two, three, four, five, six. Six out there, six people, and we got Dan and Kim. That's eight people. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
At least they outnumbered the band this week.
One more, you're going to have to hire an usher.
Yeah. Anyway, so, Jerry?
Yes?
You're back. Come and get us.
Key of E. We got the rockabilly here, so we got to do this.
That's all right with you. That's all right, Mama. Any way that you do, that's all right.
It's all right.
That's all right.
It's all right.
That's all right now, Mama. Any way that you do. Well, Mama, she done told me. Papa done told me too. I don't feel you fooling with. She ain't no good to you. That's all right.
That's all right.
Baby, that's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right now, Mama, any way that you do. Swing it, Bob!
Lord, it won't be long. You'll look for me, my baby, then I will be gone. Baby, that's all right.
That's all right.
Baby, that's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right now, mama, any way that you do.
Paul Marshall on the electric Fender bass.
Jerry, love you, man. Sounding great. So, Swan, do another one.
All right. One more. No, I'll tell you what. Call me lonesome. G, one, two. One, two, three.
Oh, lonesome.
I never heard it done that way before.
No, you may never again.
I know, and maybe not. Who knows? So,
the police are here.
What time is it?
I started out the wrong song on the wrong key and the wrong day of the week. And
well, we're gonna do. We'll do a couple more.
I didn't even know what I was doing.
We got the guest artists up here tonight, Jerry Mendelson, and go ahead and do another one.
Okay. We have to do Folsom, right? Because we got all.
Let's do it. I love Folsom.
These guys want to hear more guitar solos.
Absolutely. It's a guitar show.
Paul actually texted me before the show. He goes, can we have more guitar solos?
Absolutely.
Please.
I said,
who do you think you are, Jimmy Nelson? Because, you know, when you do Jimmy's gig, it's like 20 minutes of guitar solo. Good. I love you, Jimmy. If you're listening, I love you. There goes that gig.
Who just walked in?
I didn't. I don't recall getting a vote.
I
got to
hear more guitar solos.
Somebody just walked in. I can't see who it is.
No, he's from Maryland.
Hey! I hear that train a coming, rolling round the bend. I ain't seen the sunset since I don't know when. Well, I'm stuck in Folsom prison. Life keeps grabbing on. That train keeps moving on down to San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Burbank just to watch him die. Every time I hear that whistle, I hang my head and cry. Make it cry, Bobby, make it cry. I Well, there's probably rich folks sitting in a fancy dining car. They might be drinking coffee, smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. 'Cause I'm in love with Carmine Sardo, and that's what tortures me. Carmine! Railroad train was mine. I'm probably moving on just a little bit further down the line. Far from Folsom, that's where I want to stay. And I let that lonesome whistle carry my blues away. Gary Schwann. If that railroad train was mine, I'd move it all just a little bit further down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. Hey, hey. And I let that lonesome whistle carry my blues away.
Just like we rehearsed it.
Yeah. Down the line, far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I let that lonesome whistle carry my blues away.
End of that with like some kind of a jazz chord. Dan Hugot's pointing at me. What are you telling me? 1 minute to do what? We can't do anything in a minute around here. So we're going to do one more song. So wait, Susie's pointing too. What? Who said hello? Oh, good. Oh yeah. Hi. So, yeah, I know who you are. Somebody help me. Okay, we're gonna go. This is our last song. We're gonna go over about 3 minutes. You want to close the show? Or you just want to pick on this one? Whatever you want to do. You're the guest artist. Let's do another one, Jerry.
I don't know the words.
The words to what?
My daddy said you're going to drive me to
what's drink. The song we're talking about?
You want to do You Ain't Going Nowhere?
That's let's do it. Great song. Yeah. That's a good song to end on.
Did Charlie
we'll
Cardo?
All play on and we'll have fun. Dan, we're going to go over about 3 minutes. Hey, folks, thanks for watching. Tell all your friends. The show's been doing good lately with the viewership going up every week a little bit. So we love you all, and it's our last song of the night. It's Susie's birthday. She brought a cake. I forgot to mention
happy
it.
Birthday.
My lovely wife, after 52 years, turned 75 years old this week. And anyway, we brought a little cake, and we've been partying all week. We had a party down at Knoxbury Farm for her. We all went out to dinner with her family to the spaghetti factory. I'll tell you what, I fed a lot of people that night. It's okay. It was a good night, and they needed to eat anyway. So, okay, Jerry, take us home.
Fly so swift, the rain won't lift. The gate won't close, cause the rain's froze. And get your mind out for winter time. Tomorrow's the day and my bride's gonna come. Oh no, we gonna fly down in the easy chair. Well, I don't care how many letters they sent. The morning came and the morning went. Pack up your money and pick up your tent. You ain't going nowhere. Tomorrow's the day my bride's gonna come. Oh no, we gonna fly down in the easy chair.
Bobby.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.